Rabotai, today is election day. We got a very interesting Shacharit. Is a person allowed to vote before tefillah? Polls open at 6 o'clock. Nitzachama is a little bit thereafter. A person doesn't want to get stuck in the line. Is a person allowed to go to vote before tefillah Shacharit? Very interesting question. The Shulchan Aruch in Siman Petit says, Lo ya'aseh adam tzerechah kodem sheyitpallel. A person is not allowed to engage in his own things, in his own pursuits, before he prays. So, for that reason, that's considered a business deal or things of that nature. Anything of a person's own business is not allowed to do before the tefillah. The question becomes, what happens if it's not his own business? The Magen Avraham brings down from the Seder Ayom, Rabbeinu Moshe HaMachiri, he says, is a person allowed to go on Friday, is a person allowed to go shopping for Shabbat things before Tefillat Shacharit on Friday morning? So, the Magen Avraham brings down, he says, no, you can't, unless by the time Shacharit is over, you're not going to be able to find what you need. If you're going to run out of any of the Shabbat foods or Shabbat things that you need by the time Shacharit is over, that's the only way you're allowed to go shopping or go do things for Shabbat before Shacharit on Friday morning. Many posts can bring down the Seder Yom Halacha, the Magen Avraham, Knesset HaGdola, and others. Nevertheless, the Pri Chadash, Rabbeinu Chizkiya Siwa, explains that, says a person may, is miyashet minhag for people to go shopping before Shacharit on Friday morning. And he says the reason for that is, what the Chachamim forbade is doing a person's own pursuits. It says, Asuna la'adam la'asot tzirachav kodem sheyitpallel. Tzirachav ve'lo tzorkei shamayim. Anything that is mitzvah oriented, anything that has to do with the mitzvah, is allowed to be done before Shacharit. Now, based on that, about voting, the question would become, voting is the question. Voting, if you look at it, are you going to be able to vote? Are the votes still going to be there? Are the polls still going to be there after the tefillah? Yes. So according to the Magen Avraham and others, preferably, if you have other time, you should do it after the tefillah. But according to the Pri Chadash, voting certainly has an element of the mitzvah to it. First of all, we are doing our ishtadlut and securing our future. We are following the words of the Chachamim. So voting has to do certainly with several mitzvot. So according to the Pri Chadash and others, even if a person would be able to vote after the tefillah, since it's an element of Chavtei Shamayim, a person would be, technically, according to the letter of the law, allowed to vote before the tefillah. Now after we prayed, it's already irrelevant, but the point is, get out there and vote. I posted the letter from Rav Moshe Feinstein in Tafshin Mem Dalet, 1984, about the importance of voting. A person should never think, you know, this is a red state or blue state, my vote doesn't matter anyway. Those are machshavot shel ha-satan. A person who has machshavot shel ha-satan thinks like that. However, a person should has to go and do his ishtadlut, kifi mitzvat chachamenu, and go and vote whether you think it makes a difference or not. You go because that's what HaKadosh Baruch Hu told, you know, well, he didn't tell us, but the Chachamim told us, and they're representatives of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So we have to do our ishtadlut, and Be'ezat Hashem HaKadosh Baruch Hu yirachem alenu, and he will, you know, at the end of the day, Shlomo HaMelech writes in Mishle, Pargemayim lev melech biyad Adonai lechol asher yachpotz yatena. The hearts of kings are in the hands of God, and a Kadosh Baruch Hu will channel them whichever way He wants.